Views expressed on this program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of this station, its management, or other advertisers.
You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio.
Hi, welcome. This is Dr. John DeMartini. This is one of the most amazing and inspiring shows that you can listen into. If you want to be on the edge of your seats, if you want to open up your heart, if you want to expand your mind, and you want to meet incredible people, stay tuned because you're just about to experience a transformative radio show that will change your life. And you're listening to the Dr. Pat Show that's coming up right next.
Welcome to the Dr. Pat Show, talk radio to thrive by. Powerful, inspiring, and coming to you live, bringing you stories of people like you and me, busting through and living life full out. Get ready to dare to wonder what your life would be like if you knew you could not fail.
Hey, everybody, I want to welcome you to the Dr. Pat Show. This is Talk Radio to Thrive By. Welcome, everybody. For more information about us, we've made it pretty easy for you to do. Go to the website, the Dr. Pat Show, or just go to Dr. Pat Show, or just go to Dr. Pat B, or just go to Dr. Talk Radio. It doesn't matter. We've made a million ways for you to get there. The other way to do it is go to Transformation Talk Radio or go to TTRnetwork.com, TransformationTalkRadio.com. So somebody said to me that we had to make it really easy to get to all of the websites. So now we have like 50 different shades of how to get to the Dr. Pat Show and to Transformation Talk Radio. What an interesting exercise that is. Well, I want to welcome all of you to the show today. Michael Shane is in the house, and I'll be introducing him in a minute. But I want to give a shout out to Mr. Benny. Hello, Mr. B.
Hello.
How are you today?
Doing good.
I saw you out there getting, you were getting napkins and stuff and doing cleanup or.
Yeah, got to take care of my host.
I know you. Good job. I appreciate it.
Oh, I'm sorry. What? Did that slip? What? What's going on? What? Oh, my God. Oh, my God. It's someone's birthday today. Oh, my God. That's right. Oh, it's Dr. Pat's
birthday. Who the heck's birthday is it today?
Who set this up?
Who said birthday? Ah. Oh, Peppermint Patty.
Compliments of Taylor, too.
Oh, my God. Thank you, Taylor.
Happy 21st birthday.
Yay.
All right. Yeah.
That's why
we can buy her drinks now.
Yeah,
huh?
Exactly.
Yes, right. Thank you. That's why we brought extra people today, isn't it?
There you go.
Here you go. We'll get that divided up, won't we, during the break. Thank you so much, Peppermint Patty. Peppermint and chocolate, right?
It's only the best.
Good job, guys. Thank you so much. Yes. What do you think about the song choices I sent you? Did you think I was losing my mind?
No.
I was torn. There was a couple of other ones that I was...
Do you want me to get those on too or not worry about that right now?
No, we've got the four good ones, right? Okay. Did you think I was slightly depressed when I sent those to you last night? What were you thinking? What the wrong with her?
And I know who's
usually
coming in for
upbeat.
Today.
I'm usually an upbeat kind of... Right, Michael?
Yeah.
You know, I'm pretty upbeat. So I'm usually, let's play some Poppy, let's play Rihanna. So all of a sudden, I get in this mood, and I don't know why. I think I got off, let me just move that mic down. I think I got off on a little rant because I was watching The Voice, you know, that reality show where they sing. And I was thinking to myself, you know, a couple of people sang great songs. But I was thinking, if I were a female, a pop, with a great voice, what would be some of the songs I would sing? You know, what would be something that I would relate to that would really show my vocals? And you could see I'm trying to fix my shirt. I don't even think I got dressed today. Did I fix my collar? Is it good? And so I went through and I picked some songs.
I hope you got dressed today.
I just have to figure this out. And so I pick what I think is one of my all-time favorite songs. Was Sinead O'Connor a one-hit wonder, or was it the whole album?
Well, a little bit, but then she did her little thing on SNL, you know, tore up the picture of the Pope. Remember that?
That wasn't too cool. Look at Michael's.
Yeah, he's throwing
that. Is, you could have some strange juju from that, right?
Yeah, you gotta be careful with stuff like that.
You gotta be careful with stuff. Are we superstitious or it's just a vibe of thing? But Prince wrote that song. Prince wrote that song.
I didn't know that.
Yes, I'm telling you, he wrote that song. And, you know, it is, when I listen to that song, even today, and we're going to play it for you in a little bit. I still get really emotional, and I'm not quite sure why. Michael would probably say it's a past life. Michael Shane joining us here on the show today. It's great to have you, Michael. Welcome.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure, and happy birthday.
Thank you.
I do have a small little announcement for you, though.
Okay. And should I introduce you?
This is his birthday gift.
Actually, let's do the announcement. I'll introduce you later.
Okay. The announcement is Master Jesus
yes.
is cooking up you a really beautiful birthday and Christmas present.
Yeah.
That you're going to receive soon.
Benny.
Don't do that to me. You make me nervous.
Okay. You're laughing over there.
She
See,
knows.
That's just what we bring these. You're okay. Thank you.
I'm not sure if it's going to be today or will it be the next time, but I already know what it is, but I'm not going to tell you what
okay.
it is.
Okay. No, I'm okay. I'm cool with that. For those of you that don't know what we're talking about, Michael Shane is joining us here today. Of course, he is the founder of the Ascension Foundation. And actually, today you're going to hear about the gift of giving in a huge, huge way. But, you know, today what you should know about Michael is, you know, he has been on a spiritual journey. And, you know, he's what we know as, for those of you that don't know about this, he's what we know as a transphysical phenomenon medium. And that means that he brings things forth from the ethereal world. He brings things forth in material form. You know, we've met a lot of people that do readings and do other things, but you do that as well. You also channel and connect with the ascended masters. But when I say bring things forward, we've had you on the show. We've had you bring rubies forward. You've been in the presence of Wayne Dyer and, you know, have contributed largely for this phenomenon's success in the world today. You've got to feel like you're at a special place in this journey.
Most of my life, I would say. I mean, obviously there's always trials, but it's, I got to say, I mean, if there's a word, I'd say it's been fun.
You're just warming up. What do you mean it's been fun? Yeah, where are you going? We got a lot more to do. Well, today, Michael, we're talking about the gift of giving and what that means and what the Ascension Foundation, you know, is all about, what you've put together. Let's take a minute and talk about what it means to give. What is the power of giving all about? And why is that, you know, such an energy and a vibration these days?
Well, I heard about, you know, give
yeah.
from a very young age. And I used to give away my stuffed animals. I used to have all kinds of stuffed animals. People would give me stuffed animals. I still have stuffed animals in my car. I mean, I got them on my windshield and stuff. And I used to give them away to the girl next door or my friend up the street when I could see that they were feeling down in the dumps. Because what makes you more happier than holding a stuffed teddy bear or something like that? And that was kind of how I was throughout my whole life. And then at one point I got in trouble for giving away my stuff. But
yeah, me too. What is up with that?
I know. You give something away.
And it's like, dang, why did you give that to little in my neighborhood? Why'd you give that to Vito? Why not?
Yeah.
Right.
He probably needed it. So, and my wife, who's here with me today, may not know this, but there was a time where money was flowing, and I just felt like to give away $10,000 to a homeless person. So I did. And there's this person sitting there, and you got to be careful because sometimes the masters will appear as homeless people to see.
Oh,
if
I see.
You know, but this
to
was,
check your consciousness,
yeah.
right? Yeah.
But I was driving by, and we're at a light, and I told the guy come over, and he was missing a leg, you know, said he was in Vietnam on his sign and
yeah.
things. And I handed it to him, and I could see him in my rearview mirror as I'm pulling away. He fell on the ground.
Wow.
In shock, I would assume. The feeling that you have in your heart when you're giving something like that away from either a teddy bear or the $10,000, I noticed the feeling was the same.
Right.
Didn't matter how much it was or how little it was. It was what it meant to give something to someone that took that energy mm-hmm. and become in the graces of healing, God, love, light, and hope. And that was, it's really undescribable. The meaning of it, you know, think of Jesus. He was all about giving.
Right, right. I think that is a great example, you know, to talk about because, you know, we forget that there is an exchange energy in the world. You know, we do forget that. I think that you go to work, you get a paycheck, most people do. Some people are not, you know, so fortunate right now, so they're doing other things to recreate their lives. But, you know, we are developing such a scarcity mentality that we've become very close to holding on to things that we don't need to hold on to. And what 2012 has meant to me and a lot of other people that I know, it's been a year of letting go. It's been a year of releasing. And, you know, we've talked about the energy of 2012 and the end of the world. Well, it has really turned out for a lot of folks to be the end of the life that they thought they had. With the opportunity to create the life that you've always desired to have. And that has been an enormous opening for so many people. And like any change, Michael, it does take a little effort and pain, and there is loss, you know, of change. The question becomes, how long do we want to stay in that pain?
Till we choose to swim out of that puddle.
That's right, till we choose to swim.
Choice, free
and
will.
If you've ever seen me in the water, you would have used a different metaphor for that. But I will tell you.
A plunger?
That's right. You know, I'm telling you, you don't want to get me next to water. I do a little doggy paddle. Swimming was never something that I could learn. But I love the water and I love the ocean. Michael Shane is in the house. We are going to be taking your calls throughout the show. So let me just let you know that we are going to be opening up these phone lines, 1-800-930-2819, 1-800-930-2819. If you would like to have an on-ear reading with Michael and the Ascended Masters, that's what today's show is about, along with Michael and I making sure that all of you out there understand the power of giving, and it doesn't matter what you think you have or you don't have. Giving is something that doesn't require a big bank account. We're going to take a short break. We'll be right back with some peppermint cupcakes and my very special guest, Michael Shane, on the Dr. Pat Show. We'll be right back.
I hear the ticking of the clock. I'm lying here, the room's pitch dark. I wonder where you are tonight.
The root cause of disease is not what you think. Doctors are treating the symptoms, not the root cause, because they haven't been trained to do so. Dr. Alex Lloyd has developed a simple technique that has saved thousands of people from lives of frustrating and debilitating illnesses. This technique has been featured on national broadcast and cable television in People, Time, and USA Today. If you are ready to heal and tired of being treated, visit DrAlexHealingCodes.com, where you will find free life-changing information.
Did anyone teach you to be a parent? What if there were tools that could make your job a whole lot easier? Glenna Rice invites you to be the questionable parent you truly be in a dynamic teleseries designed to empower parents to know that they know and give you the awareness required to create ease and joy between you and your children. Check out GlennaRice.com to learn more and to book a private session or dial 415-235-2807.
Change your coffee experience forever with Camino Island Coffee Roaster. Fair trade, certified organic, shade-grown delicious coffee. The Camino Island Coffee Roasters are giving back. Receive a free pound of the most popular single origin coffee, Papua New Guinea, to the first 100 callers. The number is toll-free, 855-438-8671. Just pay $8.95 shipping and handling, and you can try triple certified coffee for yourself. The number is toll-free, 855-438-8671. This is a free pound of coffee that retails at $16.95. Once you've tried this coffee, you will automatically be enrolled in the Coffee Lovers Club for free and will always receive free shipping and nearly 30% off retail of your coffee orders. This coffee is going to knock your socks off. That number again is 855-GET-TOP-1. We say top one because this coffee is the top 1% grade. That's 855-438-8671.
Get ready for Intentional Living with Deborah Diane every Monday at 3 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on Transformation Talk Radio. Create your best life by releasing subconscious limiting beliefs and patterns quickly and easily. Each show features a live call-in segment so that you can experience Deborah's intuitive insight and powerful clearing. Deborah's quick wit and spot-on intuition make every show both powerful and fun. For more information, visit ConsciousRepatterning.com.
Tune in each week on TransformationTalkRadio.com, Wednesday at 2 Pacific, 5 Eastern Time, and express and experience the infinite possibilities waiting in each and every moment as you listen to From the Heart with Elizabeth Cookson. Get ready for a packed hour of laughter, tears, and a soul full of emotions as Elizabeth raises your vibration and shifts your spirit. For more information about Elizabeth and to schedule a session, visit ElizabethCookson.com.
And the night goes by so very slow. Oh, I hope that it won't end though. I've always got by on my own. I never.
Okay, I'm not going to sing that. I love that version, Benny. Thank you. Heart, that's the group from Seattle. And they are amazing still. And they actually did a version of this song not too long ago. And the song is Alone but, with Carrie Underwood. And that was. That was really amazing. There is on YouTube, if you're interested, there are videos, one of the original videos of this band back in 1977, before they made their whole production change. And they were hippie-ish singing in that first debut. Very different than what they've been, we've all come to know them about, but the vocals and the band are still great. Joining me here today is on our Psychic Solutions Hours, Michael Shane. For those of you out there, we are taking your calls. I want to make sure that you know 1-800-930-2819. Today's show is about the power of giving. And Michael Shane and the Ascension Foundation not just talk about giving, but they create opportunities. Michael, tell everyone a little bit about the opportunity that you all have created for someone out there, a family out there today.
Well, it takes us back a year. We were in Maui doing a giveaway donation. Master Jesus sent me a message suggesting that we do 4 or 5 hours of integration of his spirit into my physical body, to do hands-on healing to people for $5 a person,
mm-hmm.
To take the money from those proceeds to give to the local food bank over there. Well, while I was sitting on the plane on the way back, I was thinking about that. And I got to thinking, well, why can't we do something like that here? So we were beating our heads silly trying to figure out what would be unique.
Right.
So I came up with the idea, why don't we do this once a month for a year, and then the proceeds, all the monies that come in from that time period would go to give to a family in need.
Wow.
And it's so we came up with $1,000, and we want to give it to one of your listeners who knows a family in need.
So
Christmas.
For Christmas. So what they have to do is they have to send an email describing this. And, you know, Benny has, we have the promotion on that, don't we? Do you have it like up and available? And I'd like to play it so that everybody can hear exactly what we're doing with that. I'll give Benny a minute, of course, kind of, you know, scooped him on that. But what we're ready? Okay, let's hit it.
We would like to ask you to join Michael Shane and the Ascension Foundation in a special holiday giveaway. Throughout the year, the Ascension Foundation has sponsored a number of amazing healing events with Michael Shane and the Ascended Masters. With the help and support of those who participated, we raised $1,000 and want to gift this to one special family this holiday season. We invite you to write in and recommend a family to receive this special gift. Please email us by midnight, Wednesday, December 19th. At info@michaelshane.com with your reason for nominating this family, their contact information, and any other information that will help us with our decisions. A panel headed by the Ascension Foundation will select the family on Friday, December 21st. Again, that's info@michaelshane.com. That's info@michaelshane.com. For more information, you can also call the Ascension Foundation at 1-800-508-6437.
Bam! That's the way you do that, Mr. Benny.
That was amazing.
That? Yeah. I had to play it. It was so good.
Should have seen me. I was in my carriage and everything. Snowing outside. Beautiful. Beautiful.
Did you have elves?
I did.
Twins?
Yes, I did. It's like you were there.
I'm hoping to do a carriage ride when I go back east. I love that. I love to take that carriage ride. It is one. Look, you're shaking your head. Isn't it one of the most romantic things you could do is take that carriage ride in New York around in Grand Central Park?
I've not done that.
I'm telling you, you guys, Michael, you guys have to really think about that. It is this time of year. Everything is lit up. It's just absolutely beautiful. It is just one of the most, it's actually one of the most special times that I can remember. Little bit cold, but it's still good. Now, Michael, let's let everybody know we're actually taking your calls today. What we're planning to do is if you have a question, if you have a comment, if you want to receive a message from the Ascended Masters, we're going to go ahead and do this. Why don't we take a couple of calls right now, and then we'll talk about, you know, why Master Jesus and why Master Jesus is so important in the Ascension Foundation and in the world today. But, Mr. Benny, where would you like to go?
Start things off in Seattle. We have Naomi on the line.
Hey, Naomi. Welcome to the show.
Oh, thank you. Hello, everyone. Dr. Shane and Dr. Pat.
How can we help you today? Yeah, it's great to hear from you.
Thank you. I just want a reading. I want to talk to the master.
All right.
Give them a word.
All right. Do you have a specific question or something you want to zoom in on?
No, actually, I just want to say hi to my big brother.
Okay.
His master Jesus.
All right. That's what I like to hear.
Well, he would like to...
Jesus is getting a lot of love these days. I got to tell
you. Well, you know, we're in Christmas time. Christmas time, you know, Master Jesus, Mother Mary.
Good point, Michael.
Yeah. So,
right. That's why you're the trans-physical phenomena. That's why. Because you get these messages.
You know, we all receive messages, but we don't always share the messages.
That's true.
But I'm going to share one right now.
Okay. Here he goes.
Man, your 2013 is going to blow your socks off. So don't bother putting any on because they're not going to stay on long. Everything from financial abundance to happiness and love to resolution of issues connected to family or a specific individual in the family to travel. Opportunities for travel will be there for you. And these things will all come throughout the course of the year. So the big message there is take care of your health.
Okay.
Take care of yourself along besides the health issue.
Okay.
Focus on generating things like colon cleanses. Okay?
Yeah.
Work on the spine to realign the spine because I'm being told it's out of whack.
Okay.
And Master Jesus would like to say that you're on the good list and that he loves you.
Thank you.
Okay. There you go. All right. Well, how do you like that message? You happy with that one?
Oh, my God.
All right. Well, that's what happens when you get Christmas early.
Hey, I'll take that anytime.
All right. Thanks, Naomi.
All right. Thank you.
All right. I wanted to mention before we go to the phones again, for those of you out there that want a reading with Michael today on the show, toll free 1-800-930-2819. We also have instant feedback message. Go to transformationtalkradio.com. On the right hand side, you could pop in your question or go to the drpatshow.com. And on the right hand side, ask a question. I'm going to have to Benny pull that up because I don't have my computer today. This is my birthday. And so I didn't want my computer today. Before we go to the phones again, Michael, tell us about the upcoming event. This is really special on the 21st.
We are doing a potluck. People that want to come, that wish to bring a dish of some kind.
I love that format.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're going to be giving away gifts from Master Jesus, Archangel Michael, the Ascended Master, Saint Germain, Buddha, Katumi, Uriel, who also is a Archangel Gabriel, and Raphael.
Mm.
So there's some others that will come through. This is going to be a apportation event with messages from the masters.
Wow.
For individuals. I mean, it's really going to help because we're not supposed to be alive the next day. So those people out there that are going to be...
That's why I picked those songs. You've got to cue in Sinead O'Connor when we come for rec. Now I know why I picked those songs. I had a moment of that.
Yeah, I mean, think about it. There will be people out there. They're going to wake up on December 22nd not knowing what to do.
I am so glad that I've had the year that I've had that I am not going to be one of those people. I think I'm real pretty clear. Now, I think you're pretty clear. I think this was a big year for you, Michael.
Well, it has been.
This was a huge year for him, right? Right.
It's been a year that I would say would be the year.
It's a great year.
You know, I got to meet a number of wonderful individuals. I've gotten to know you quite well.
Yeah.
And the masters just love you very much. And Benny over there, look at him. Beautiful children. But for me, I would have to say something has opened up in my heart that hasn't been opened up. Mm-hmm. It's been there, but it hasn't come out.
Mm-hmm.
This year, I don't really know what to define it to be, but it's there and I can feel it and I just want to share it with everybody, you know, and we talk about this giveaway that we're doing.
Right.
It's not really, we're not giving away anything. We are offering love. You know, we're handing out little pieces of love.
Right.
And there was a lot of people involved in this. The people that came and participated in these events.
Right, wow.
You know, one Sunday every month, people would come in, and they were giving. They were also receiving, but a lot of them really would have just came in and just left the money and left, you know, because they wanted to give. They wanted to give to a cause that was worthy. So I personally would like to thank everyone that came to that event each month throughout the past year who donated their time, their hard earnings, and their presence.
Mm, that's beautiful. Wow. Michael Shane is in the house. We are taking your calls, 1-800-930-2819. When we come back, we're going to be talking to Kamisha. We're going to be talking to Stacy. Benny's going to be getting your instant feedback messages. And when we come back, we're also going to be talking about Master Jesus and, you know, what this idea is of love that is being called forth in all of us. All of us. It doesn't matter what your life situation is. Every single person has an opportunity to experience that level of fulfillment. Stay tuned. We'll be right back with the Dr. Pat Show.
your love.
How would you feel if you could bring magic into your life? Here is your Essence of Gratitude tip of the day. By living the essence of gratitude within our soul at each moment of our life, we consciously choose and embody its high frequency energy, and that is when magic starts to appear. To learn more about the magic of the Essence of Gratitude, visit our website at explorationgratitude.com.
Tune into Intuit University, compassionate guidance, connecting you to your inner wisdom with internationally renowned psychic and medium, Sherry Dillard. Each Thursday at 12 Pacific, 3 Eastern. Get ready for an hour of practical spirituality, fun, and a magic carpet ride into the spirit realm. This hit show is a combination of call-in readings and intuitive mentoring, as Sherry supports, inspires, and empowers you to create your highest good in relationships, career, finances, life purpose, spirituality, and more. For more information, visit SherryDillard.com.
Grateful patients have been saying it for 25 years. When in pain, see Dr. Thane. Dr. Thane of Wellness One of Bellevue has been named one of the nation's top chiropractors by the Consumers Research Council of America, and for good reason. He has helped his patients recover their energy and vitality after car accidents, sports injuries, herniated discs, fatigue due to stress, the list goes on. The website is bellevue.wellnessone.net. When in pain, see Dr. Thane. That's bellevue.wellnessone.net.
Have you ever considered what money and sex have in common? Brenda St. Louis, founder of Know That You Know, explores the energies of debt, money, sex, and our bodies. In her four-week intensive Debt Into Delight, Getting Intimate With Your Digits, she tickles all those places we don't want to look at, infusing everything with exuberance. Would you be willing to have more money? Would you be willing to have more of you? Explore more of Brenda St. Louis at knowthatyouknow.com.
What if you could teach your child how to follow their own wisdom and make trustworthy decisions? The hit radio show Teaching from the Heart with Julie Kay does just that. Tune in Mondays at 9 a.m. Eastern Time on TransformationTalkRadio.com to learn practical and spiritual ways to teach young people how to become confident in who they are. Each week, Julie takes on tough topics that most parents dread, like bullying, peer pressure, self-esteem, social media, relationships, and even poor grades. For more information about Julie Kay, visit MindFocusGeneration.com.
Chris Stainis is a spiritual leader and healer and teaches a course on how you can transform your life through a meditation and healing system that will manifest your spirit's dreams. She manifested the Women of Wisdom Conference, the Women of Wisdom book, and this radio show. And she can show you how to change your life too. Are you ready? Visit the website and contact her at voicesofwomentoday.com. That's voicesofwomentoday.com.
Yes, that is Sinead O'Connor. And, you know, let me tell you guys, this is not like a downer thing when I pick these songs. I will tell you that a couple of these songs at the time, Sinead O'Connor's song has a lot of interpretations to it. Nothing Compares to You. And, you know, a lot of people looked at that song and thought, you know, that this was about a man. Well, many people thereafter, especially given some of the... some of the things she did out in public, came to realize that for her, a lot of the messages in that song were of a spiritual nature. And today's show is, of course, talking about the gift of giving and about Master Jesus and about, you know, some of these incredible things happening. So on December 21st, please make sure you know that this event that's happening at the Ascension Foundation is amazing. You know, I want to make sure all of you out there know that these events have many, many levels to them. Go to the website michaelshane.com or call the Ascension Foundation at 800-508-6437 to schedule your seat for these. They fill up really quickly, and we want to make sure that all of you out there are able to be part of this. Let's go to the phones.
All right. We have Kamisha in Bellevue.
Kamisha! Hey, You didn't never answer in my text messages. Did you change your phone?
Oh,
girl,
you're
hiding from me.
I answered it too.
What?
Yeah, I left you a message. I sent you one.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
Miss you, Kamisha. How are you?
I'm good. Am I on air right now?
Yes, you are.
Oh, goodness. Okay. So.
Yes.
Happy birthday, Pat.
Thank you, Kamisha.
I'm going to say happy birthday with me and Michelle. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Miss Patty Kay. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Miss Pat.
Oh, Kamisha, are you going to be like trying out for the X Factor next year? Because I know you can sing.
American Idol.
I don't know.
You have reached the maximum time permitted for recording your message.
Know.
If you are satisfied with your message,
what
is that? Press 1 to listen to your
message. Oh, wait. Kamisha,
yeah,
I love you.
I love you too. I just want to know
are
what
you
my
still there? You have
okay, I'm going to call back. Bye.
Call back.
Recording your
okay,
message.
Bye. We got a little recorder in the show. That's good. I have to tell you, it's the Ascended Masters getting in on this.
Is that what it is?
That's what it is. Doesn't she have the voice of an angel?
She does.
You should hear her sing.
I just did.
Wow. I mean, like, oh. And she has a little baby, so we got to get her back. Let's go to the phones. Let's see what we can do for Stacy.
Stacy in Edmonds, and she just wants a reading from Michael.
Hey, Stacy. How are you?
Hi.
Hey.
So excited to be at talking to you. Happy birthday, Dr. Pat.
Thank you, Stacy, in the beautiful Edmonds. Are you overlooking the water right now?
Well, yep, I can see a bit of the water. It's beautiful, even though it's gray. It's still beautiful.
It is still beautiful. How can Michael help you today?
Well, so exciting. Thank you, Michael.
Hello.
I am calling. Go ahead. Sorry.
Are you saying hello?
Hello. I am calling I'm a master practitioner of NLP, and I've studied some different modes of energy work. And the thing that attracts me the most is getting messages for other people, and I'm just not sure which way to go next with things for my career.
Well, the first thing that I would do is suggest training. There are certain energies and vibrations and knowledge that you need to actually bring through a amount of energy that can actually manifest in the physical world from the etheric. You have, from what Saint Germain is telling me, an energy such like I have. It's called ectoplasm. Ectoplasm forms from the silver cord from the spirit into the physical body, down through the spinal cord into the spinal fluid, where the spinal fluid then at that point starts to vibrate, where you actually feel it in your spine vibrating. And then it's sent throughout the nervous system of the body and finds a pinpoint area to manifest through and come out into the physical world. That's what you have this ability. And when with this ability comes a lot of responsibility and a lot of power. So you have to be very careful with that. When you see this experience happen, you're going to know exactly what to do with the individual that's in front of you for the energy work or the healing that you're capable of bringing forth, obviously with the help of the ascended masters and the angels. You do have a lot of connections to the angelic realm. I'm not being told at what capacity, but you do have a connection there. Your work has been great, but you've always kind of felt like something's missing. Is that not true?
That is true. When I feel something, it's interesting. You're talking about the spinal cord and the spinal fluid. And when I know something to be so, I'll be just chatting with somebody I don't even know. And all my cells start vibrating as they're talking to me.
Yes.
And so it resonates to me what you've said so far. And yes, it feels like I'm just sort of looking around waiting. And I don't want to just wait. I want to take action and move.
Well,
that's a good one.
Don't.
But
do not.
I'm also thinking, I'm not supposed to be, I also want to be open to what's what's before me, because right, our unconscious mind sometimes knows better, and if we just trust and
Well, you're about to have an experience with this energy. It's going to, which you're going to put into a book. It's, you know, you hear about these spiritualist books. They come out, you know, they have wonderful messages and things like that. But yours is going to be unique, more so because the message is going to be different this time. It's going to be a message of empowerment.
Mm-hmm. What do you think about that?
A book?
Yeah.
Well, I had made a couple notes while I was on hold, and one of the things I wrote down is I want to write a book.
Yeah. Well, you know, can I, Stacey? Here's the thing. This is something that this is a lesson I learned this year. Sometimes we think we're not doing anything. Okay, this was huge for me. We think we're not doing anything. Like you said, I want to do something, right? I think you said something like that. But you're already doing it. You know, sometimes we think, oh, I've got to be raking the lawn. That's doing something. But if I have a visualization that says the lawn is already raked, that's also doing something. You see?
I do know what you're saying. And yes, that's true. And that's where I have to trust and not get my conscious mind too worried about it. I just,
My gosh. You know, worry is that Sinead O'Connor song. That's worry.
There's two issues here. there is a trust or insecurity issue. Maybe you're not quite believing in yourself 100%. So you should work on that. And the other is to get some understanding or a little training to understand how to manifest the ectoplasm. And that happens to be something that I could do.
Mm.
I could help you organize that and understand how to use it and where to use it and how to manifest it and how to direct it. So you would get a hold of me. Just go to my website, www.michaelshane.com.
Yeah.
And get a hold of me if you're interested in that. If not, if you don't have the time, the other is meditation. And if you're going to meditate on bringing forth ectoplasm, you want to use a silver flame energy. So when you go into a meditative state, you are in your heart chakra bringing forth a silver flame, and you encapsulate the entirety of your body with this energy.
Yeah, I get the sense, though, you actually want to do something, though. That's the sense
I
get.
I'm sorry to interrupt.
No, go ahead.
Go ahead.
Jump in.
Well, this is the thing that brings me the most pleasure right now, where I feel the most solace as I'm moving forward is meditation. And so that just cracks me up. But of course, Michael, you say that. This helps me to relax about it all and not to worry and to know that I'm on the right path. It's that thing of, you know, just some days you think, oh gosh, I need to be doing the next thing. And I have to relax and trust in the process.
Yeah, you know what? You did the next thing right now today. You called into the show so you could get this message.
And there is a truth
there
here.
There you go. I like that.
You did. Yeah, I mean, see, this is what I'm trying to say. Doing things, we're so used to in this society, Michael. Michael and I have talked about this on a previous show. We're so used to doing in a mega way that we have not paid attention to the nuances of doing. And, you know, when doing and being are one, okay, can you hear what I'm saying? When doing and being are one, you cannot distinguish between them. You understand what I'm saying?
I do.
Okay.
I do. It resonates. Definitely.
Yeah. When doing and being are one, that is the most divine connection we could have to any of the masters. And so sometimes we don't trust that. And we look for one or the other while we're already in the integration and the synthesis, right? That's what Jesus was all about. Jesus was all about the doing and the being at one time.
And he did it.
And he did
You're
it.
Right.
You know,
he did.
The thing is he believed something or in principle exercised this one thing.
Yeah.
You were talking about not knowing whether or not you're on the right path. Well, the truth is, as Jesus teaches us, there's no wrong path.
Mm-hmm.
We are where we're supposed to be for that moment based on the dynamics of our existence. we take our actions and our intent to decide which door we want to walk through.
Yeah.
Well, I do feel very strongly I'm on the right path. It's just that idea of that doing, and it's just that I just have to relax. And like I called today, like Dr. Pat said,
you're doing.
I am doing.
Yeah, I mean, well, if you're going to stay with Jesus, one of the things he said, and Janie, you're going to have to correct me on this if I get this wrong, greater things than these you shall do. Right? You
right.
shall do. He didn't say you shall be. You see? So many people, you know, look at some of the masters. Some of the masters, right, Michael, you get a sense of them. They're kind of sitting on a throne. Jesus walked around an entire countryside. You know, this was a guy that was all about the doing. You know, he didn't say, oh, let's have a meditation. He said, let's have a supper. You know, I mean, it's a different way of looking at things. You know, there are other masters, right? Michael's the master.
144,000 that are associated with this earth plane.
Okay, so I guess some of them are being, but Master Jesus, not one of them.
He's one of the top.
I think if he was around today, he'd be like some CEO.
He is around today.
Yeah. Okay. There we go. Stacy, thank you so much. Okay. Are you good to go?
Thank you so much.
You bet.
Thank you.
All right. Let's go to the phones. I think Miss Kamisha is back and she would love to connect with Michael. Kamisha, great to have you. How's the baby? Taylor's like, what's happening?
I don't think she's there.
Kamisha. She's probably on the other end saying, I could hear them and I'm talking, but they can't. Kamisha, hello.
Or maybe she
called back, Kamisha.
We'll put a binky in the baby's mouth.
We do have some instant feedback, though.
All right. We do.
So
go ahead, Taylor.
Maple
way to go.
Valley is just looking for a general reading regarding her health, relationship, and wealth from Michael.
And this is Alice.
Alice from Maple Valley.
Sweet.
Well, this Alice does not have to jump down the rabbit hole.
Okay.
When it comes to health, it's just basically changing some of her things that she does with her life. Stay in tune with vegetables, high vegetables with a lot of oxygen and minerals and things in it.
Those would be the greens.
Yes.
The green ones. Yeah.
Not enough of that.
Right. Yeah. Don't go out and get yourself a big old sweet potato.
Yeah. No sweet potatoes. Stay away from the pasta and start eating healthy. The relationship that she's been looking for mostly is one that she can grow with, right? And that, it's like, Katumi is the one that's communicating to me right now, and he's saying that is coming for her, but don't focus on it. Just allow it to happen in time and on time. As far as finances are concerned, the masters are laying it on her, meaning it's her responsibility. Pick herself up and go make her fortune. If she utilizes that energy within herself that she has, which is very powerful,
okay,
she will receive what it is that she's looking for.
Okay, good.
In that department.
I think Kamisha's calling back. What else do you have back there?
I think it's going to be Kamisha as soon as we get her back on.
Is that her?
I don't think it's her. As of right now, that's it for the instant feedback.
All right. Well, Kamisha is calling back because I know Kamisha. She is not going to give up. She will call back in this show even after the show's over. Let's talk about the Master Jesus for a moment. You know, we have been talking about him throughout the show today. It's one of the many masters you work with. But what is it about the energy of Master Jesus in this time of year that is so powerful, Michael? I mean, I know what it is for me, but what is it in general that's become so universal?
Well, it's really not in general. If you think about Master Jesus or Jesus, Yeshua, okay, you think about sacrifice.
Mm-hmm.
You think about forgiveness, and you think about what he went through, and we could only think about it. We couldn't possibly fathom what it was.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, not even the movie that came out really showed what he really went through.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? That is the answer to your question. That's why it's out there. Every time somebody has something positive happening to them, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Every time something bad happens,
mm-hmm.
who do they blame? Jesus and God. So there's a balance in a
right,
way there, right?
Right, right.
Because we remember all these things that this man did.
Mm-hmm.
He traveled to India. He traveled to Asia. He traveled, lived in Egypt.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? All over the Middle East. You know, and most of the time on foot. You know, how many people in this world today do you know do that?
Well, that's what I was saying. I mean, we have this idea of the masters and, you know, the spiritual energy. And it is about being, but it's not only about being. And, you know, the Dalai Lama travels to more places around the globe, taking that message of joy. Well, speaking of joy, we do have Miss Kamisha on the line. Hello, Miss Kamisha. How can Michael help you today?
Hey, I just want to get a reading.
I'm all right.
Curious about 2013.
You're curious about 2013?
And now, too. But
okay.
Yes, I would love to hear what you have to say.
All right.
Well, I have been looking. I'm the kind of person that gives readings in a kind of a different manner. I listen to messages that I receive from the masters. And sometimes the message isn't always taken as a very positive thing. But okay. None of that is actually happening. I mean, the last 3 months, it's been nothing but positive readings that I've been giving to people. And it's not because this is an attempt to feed people's egos. This is an attempt to show that there is positive in our life, which you are going to receive not only in 2013, but also the remainder of 2012. You got a beautiful child who, by the way, is very gifted. If you haven't figured that out yet, will play a role in this world of change. And also, you're not going to have to worry too much about coming up with funds for education because this child will already have that worked out. So scholastic and sports, I mean, all those kind of things will be there for scholarships. That's the word I was looking for.
Yeah, whatever it is, whatever form it's going to take in the future,
right.
he will be well cared for.
Yeah, just a lot of love there around this child. I mean, a lot.
Yeah, I know.
And that love is what's cultivating this child to grow up to be a great person.
Mm-hmm.
But the other thing is, you are raising this child.
Yeah.
You're teaching this child principles that in most cases are lost in the now.
Mm.
I was told last year that 2013 is the beginning of the new way of thinking and 2012 was the end of the old way of thinking.
Mm, yeah, boy.
And that is a message directly for you specifically because now you're going to change the way you were thinking before. It doesn't matter if it was good or bad.
Mm-hmm.
And go into your new way of thinking around this child, around your life, around your love environment, your relationships, not just with a mate, but with friends and family, being there for them, being the shoulder that you really are. I mean, you if you're not in this industry, you should have been, and that was in the counseling part of our lives to help people because you have such a big heart.
She does.
Thank you.
She does.
But in closing on this, I want you to know, all you have to do every day is breathe.
Mm.
And the rest of it is going to come naturally, and you're going to be very happy.
Mm.
And you can let Pat know about all of this, because I hear that you two know each other.
Yeah. Hey, let's have lunch Friday.
Yeah,
absolutely.
All right. All right. There we go.
Oh,
right.
One last thing.
One last
thing. I'm being told, look for the present wrapped in the red paper.
Okay, that's for you, Kamisha.
Thank you. Look for the present wrapped in the red paper.
And thank you for a beautiful, beautiful song. Thank you so much.
Oh, happy birthday. Thank you, Michael.
You are so welcome. Merry Christmas.
Yeah, and Michael Shane, thank you, Michael, for joining us here today. You and I are going to do some really cool stuff. I'm so looking forward to it. Don't forget to check out the event on the 21st. Go to michaelshane.com, M-Y-C-H-A-E-L. Shane, S-H-A-N-E.com. Thank you all for tuning us in, turning us on. We'll see you next time on the Dr. Pat Show.
Lights go out and I can't be saved. Tides that I tried to swim against. Put me down upon my knees. Oh, I beg and plead. Singing, come out of things unsaid. Shoot an apple off my head. And a trouble that can be...
You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio. Our hosts are setting a new standard for a fresh kind of talk radio, creating conversations that are transforming the world, one listener at a time. Transformation Talk Radio's mission is to broadcast a distinct blend of live talk radio interviews with a mix of uplifting and intelligent news, educational and practical information. Topics range from personal development to critical issues relevant to a rapidly changing world. Stay tuned. Transformation Talk Radio starts at the top of every hour. Transformation Talk Radio showcases a distinct blend of live talk radio interviews with a mix of uplifting and intelligent news, education, and practical information. Topics range from personal development to critical issues relevant to a rapidly changing world. Our hosts bring together some of the planet's most preeminent and visionary change makers, best-selling authors, motivational speakers, leading-edge scientists and futurists, environmentalists and educators, world-renowned spiritual leaders, inventors, filmmakers, artists, mystics, and healers that are stimulating and supporting individual and collective growth. Get ready to create positive cultural shifts on Transformation Talk Radio. Join us in making a meaningful difference in the world. TransformationTalkRadio.com. That's TransformationTalkRadio.com. Transformation Talk Radio, a higher consciousness perspective. The hosts on Transformation Talk Radio offer a positive and new paradigm shift, a new vision for a collective future. They are empowering and helping all of us experience a powerful wave of personal shifts and cultural change as we break through to even greater levels of awareness. Take down our toll-free number, 1-800-930-2819. Call in, connect. Make sure you tap into some of the world's most empowering psychics, healers, and more. Get an on-air reading with the best. Tune in. TransformationTalkRadio.com. Hey, everybody. We'll see you there.